top tips for getting into investment banking. Top tip number one, start young. What I mean by this, in terms of sixth form, there are schemes that are available for you to be able to have work experience immediately when you've finished sixth form. The faster you get onto these schemes, not only are you developing your vocabulary and your understanding of the concepts and the principles at work, but you're networking. And if they like you, they will often fast track you. But Gwyn, the competition is so intense. Yes, competition is intense, so open the net a little bit wider. It might not be an investment banking firm itself, but it might be a financial services firm. It might even be a financial services authority, or it might be a FTSE 100 firm. Top tip number two for investment banking. In investment banking, more than I would say any other business sector, the vocabulary changes, and it changes very, very quickly. Yes, you can track what's happening through Bloomberg, you can track what's happening through CityAM, and you need to make a note of new changes that are taking place. For example, until recently, few people had heard of dark pools. Within the last couple of weeks, hopscotch loans has become the new phrase of the week. What you're after is being current with the ideas and the concepts now, and able to talk about those stories and understand it, because it happens at interviews. So, what do you understand by dark pools? What do you understand by hopscotch loans? If those stories have been big in the press and you haven't caught on to it, you're in trouble. Next tip for getting into investment banking: get a first and or do an interesting dissertation. Clearly, the competition is very high, and certainly you need to be getting a high 2-1 over 65. If you get a first, it will actually make you stand out. Choice for dissertation: make it relevant to what it is that you're applying for. Make it corporate finance focused, make it trading focused, make it mergers and acquisition focused in an area that genuinely interests you. Similarly, be able to justify your module choices in year two and year three. Think ahead, think strategically. Next tip for getting into investment banking is take advantage of the clubs and societies at your university. It's really important that you join the finance society or the investment society in year one. Why? Because it will help you network and get ahead and hopefully get promoted onto the organizing committee in year two. Why is that important? Because in year two, you get to meet the banks first when they come and visit your university. You get to have contact with the HR department. Back to year one, you're learning the vocabulary. And often, these investment societies, investment clubs will get involved in competitions, and you could be given the role of having to research the TMT sector. You might be given the role of researching the energy sector. And again, you're learning. All the way through, you're learning. Go to events. This is like having a part-time job. Yes, you've got to get your high 2-1 or your first, and you've got to research the applications that you're going to make, and you need to go to the events to get the business cards, to make the contacts, and get information from these people that is going to make your application stand out. Finally, you'll have seen in one of the previous tips I was talking about the clubs and the societies and the events that you go to. And yes, you're going to get these business cards, and you're going to get contact with people. The final tip is about maintaining contact. People will want to help you. They do, honestly. Presumably, you're all going to have a LinkedIn account, and you're going to be able to search and check and find out who are the graduates from your university who are currently working for certain banks. Get in touch with people. Ask to meet them for a coffee. When you get these business cards, send people an email. Maintain contact. The more that you can establish relationships with people, the more that you can keep it personal, the more chance you have of getting ahead.